The Arabs hold no bounds when it comes to spending money on luxury and extravagant properties. Everything they touch turns to gold, and they have no shortage of funds to fuel their ambitions. And on the latest projects planned to come out of Saudi Arabia is a mixture of an architectural wonder. So in this video, we're going to talk about Maqab, a giant Q-shaped building that is supposed to be a museum, technology and design university, and a multi-purpose theater. Tag along till the end of this video to find out all the latest news and plans for this yet another mega project soon to happen in Saudi Arabia. Saudis don't just make a noise, but they also deliver of their projects like the Neon City or the Line. The Maqab is no short of a wonder itself. From what the officials have told, it would be a large Q-shaped structure, and it will be large enough to hold 20 Empire State Buildings. The structure is said to be 400 meters tall and 400 meters wide and will make the new downtown centerpiece in the city of Riyadh. It will be a part of a developmental project named New Maraba that is aimed to transform a 19 square kilometers area located to the northwest of Riyadh. Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman himself announced the project, and it will be done by a new company that His Majesty established in 2021 named the New Maraba Development Company. The building is going to be based on the modern Injadi architectural style, which demonstrated the use of clay mud renderings, stone columns, triangular openings, and geometric motors. Of course, mud and stone columns won't be a part of this construction, but all the design elements will be inspired by Injadi architecture with a futuristic twist. The building will enclose a tower on top of a spiral base. Combined, it will have a mind-boggling 2 million square meters of space of floor space. You can try, but you can never make it around the whole city in a single walk, or even multiple walks for that matter. There will be elevators and conveyor belts to move around. Since it's going to be impossible, however, the space here will be much needed for it to be a hospitality destination. There are going to be all the top retail brands, fashion brands, and much more to attract tourists, but the main thing I am most excited about is that it will have residential units, meaning if you have the dough, you can live in a city that is built inside of a city. There are going to be hotels, commercial spaces for businesses, and recreational facilities. The total number of these units is said to be 104,000 residential units, 9,000 hotel rooms, 980,000 square meters of retail space, and 1.4 million square meters of office space. With 1.8 million square meters of space dedicated to community facilities, the New Maraba project is set to become a model for sustainable urban development. It will have green areas to make a statement on the sustainability pact, and will also tell the world that modern technology does not mean we have to destroy the planet. You will be able to walk around on green pavements, or use your bicycle to get around to promote a healthy lifestyle. Since it is designed to be like a city, there is going to be a museum, details of which are yet to be disclosed, but is simply awe-inspiring. History of the world and a region will probably be displayed inside this amazing structure to showcase the progress mankind has made. There is going to be a University of Technology and Design, which is a perfect way to complement this marvel of engineering. The project is set to be completed by year 2030, which is a very slim timeline for such a huge project. However, there is no denying that the track record of Arabs when making huge buildings is so well that they can absolutely pull this off as well. People who will be lucky enough to live in this city will have access to living, working, and entertainment areas all within a 15-minute walking radius. Some of you might argue that this will disconnect them from the rest of the world, but that's not true. Anyone living in this marvel will have access to the outside world, and since it will be in the downtown, and just 20 minutes away from the airport, it will become a major attraction for the tourists, as well as locals traveling to the city of Riyadh. It is hard to say anything about the economic viability. However, the developer says that this project has the potential of creating more than 350,000 jobs from its construction to daily operations. So what are your thoughts on this? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the future videos. I will see you in the next one.